Look, baby Rilla, what do I do?
You thought baby Rillas were gonna be safe?
Now for me, Rilla Hops, it's a group of friends who train together, travel together, do all sorts of things. We cook, we jump, and we go eat at Chipotle. Those are the three main things we do.
My name is Gareth Norvell.
My name is Caleb Iuliano.
My name is Jeff Pritchard. The thing that started me doing parkour was a friend of mine from high school asked me if I wanted to try it with him, so I said yes.
I was on my computer with my friend, and we found a video of some guy jumping over stuff, and we're like, yo, that's awesome, that's what we gotta do.
I found a movie called District B13, which was made with the founder of parkour, so I looked him up on YouTube and saw what he was doing, and I decided I wanted to do that. I became friends with everyone at Rilla Hops different ways. I met Gareth first. I met him when he was a little kid.
One day I went out to train with him, and he told me to do things, so I did things because I had to prove myself, because I didn't want to be a bitch around him.
And now he's pretty much the main person I train with.
This is the nastiest leaf I've ever eaten.
Yeah, probably. It's so green.
When I first met Jeff, he didn't really do anything. He'd just run around in a tree all the time. He came up to stay with me in my apartment and train with me.
And then Jeff proved himself, and then we both just all got really manly.
Kale, you followed chopsticks before?
No.
Can you get better at it?
The team first got started because I was in Spain whenever I thought of it.
Caleb, Gareth, and I have been talking for a while, just in general while we were training, and we always thought it'd be very cool to have a team.
And I was sitting there and I was like, no one's giving me any opportunities, so why don't I just make it myself? So I messaged Gareth and Jeff on Facebook and I was like, let's start a team.
And he said that to me and Jeff, and then me and Jeff were like, yeah, we should do that. That sounds awesome.
Caleb made a video a few months ago called Rilla Hops 100%.
Just sounded like a perfect name to call ourselves Team Rilla Hops. The thing that makes our team really special is that we're all really close.
I got a juicer, it can make peanut butter.
That's crazy.
We're actually all just best friends.
Our team has two girls that are actually really good at parkour. So that makes us pretty unique. It's a very diverse group. We have different skill sets.
I can't do it.
And when we come together, it's just this great, unique ball of awesomeness.
There's no real difference between parkour and freerunning. It's really just the same thing. The difference in names actually came from a documentary that was done called Jump London, because parkour originated in France and parkour is a French word. So they needed a word that sounded more normal to people who speak English, so they made up free running. And then there became all these arguments on the internet that parkour is efficient and free running is about doing flips and tricks. There's really no difference though.
Jeff just decided he was gonna have level 4 climb ups today.
The way that I train is I wake up every morning,
I go outside, and I try and jump really far, and if I don't make it, I go home and cry.
I'll work a lot of control, like I'll do a lot of precisions and try to stick over and over to make sure that I have perfect control over all of my movement.
Bro, you look like a flea, just jumped a football field.
And then I also do a lot of strength training, a lot of hand balancing, gymnastics workouts.
I'll have days where I just lift, and then on other days I'll do some sort of gymnastics or calisthenics type of workout.
That's pretty much how all my training is. Injuries don't actually occur very often.
A lot of the ones that happen that are usually the worst for people are the ones that get worse over time.
Oh.
tickles so much.
It's not supposed to tickle.
You can get small injuries, like bruises, cuts, things like that.
I usually like hurt like my big toe or like bruise my heel.
Oh.
Break a finger or something. So it's never really anything that bad. What parkour means to me is whatever I want it to mean, I guess.
Parkour by itself doesn't mean very much, but parkour in combination with everything else in life is a tool to help you become the best version of yourself that you can.
For me, parkour, it's just a set of challenges. You might be training one day and you might get one thing, and before you get it, this means absolutely everything to you, but then as soon as you get it, it's absolutely meaningless. So you have to keep moving on in the chain of accomplishments, and that's what makes parkour so addictive.
Parkour for me is just the most effective tool that I've found to get me to where I want to be in life.
It's basically everything.
Our goals for the team are for us all to be able to create the life that we want, do the things that we love.
Our main goal is just to have fun and travel and progress.
Just travel around and experience life together.
And do awesome things with awesome people together.
That's really about it.
Yeah, sounds about right.
Just get ready. Crazy stuff's coming from Team Rilla Hops.
You thought baby Rillas were gonna be safe?